Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a collage from slices of images. So I'm going to go to New File, and just for this demonstration, I'm going to select A4, but I'm going to select a landscape orientation here, and then just click Create. Now you can import your images by going to File, Open, and then just selecting your images, and then click Open. But they will all open as a different document under a different tab. So the way I always do it, so I go to my file, so go to, and then select your file. Mine's in desktop. And then if I select all of these images, hold down the shift key, click at the top, then click to the bottom to select your four images, and then just simply drag and drop those images in. One will appear, but the rest won't until you tick this checkbox at the top. So click on that. The next one will appear, again click once again, and then finally for the fourth one. Now you can see they've all been inserted as smart objects on their own separate layer. So what we need to do now is to create some guides so that we've got an equal image or an equal slice of an image for our collage. So go to View, go down to Guides, and then go down to New Guide Layout. Now mine's already in because I've rehearsed this video, but in order to do the four, you need four columns, and then you need one row. Make sure everything at the bottom here is zero. You don't need any margins. And then just simply click OK. The next thing we need to do is go to View and check that our Snap 2 is on. Snap 2, and that's guides. Make sure that's checked. That means that when we select anything using this selection tool here, it means it will automatically click onto your guides. So select at the top here, click and drag out to the bottom, and it will, you can just see it snaps to those guides, which means it's really accurate. Once you've made that selection, you can decide from your images which one you want to use. You can switch on and off your layers using this eyeball tool here. And so for the far left one, I think I'm going to choose this top one here. So select this layer, you've got your selection highlighted here, go down to the bottom and select Add Layer Mask and click. You can see we've added a layer mask where it just reveals the section that we selected. Make sure this link is turned off, so just click on it. And it means that you'll be able to move your image without moving the mask. But also you can see that at the moment the mask is highlighted with that white line around it, you need to click on the image and make sure the image is highlighted. Go to your Move tool up here, and now you can move your image around. But you can see that my image doesn't quite stretch to the top and the bottom. So we need to use the Transform tool. So you can select that by going to Image, down to Transform, and just select Scale. And now to rescale this, make sure that you hold the Shift key down so that you don't distort it. If I don't hold the Shift key down, then I can distort the image, which I don't want to do. So make sure you hold the Shift key down and pull out the image until it fills the top and bottom space. Then you can simply move it to exactly where you want it. Once you've done that, just click the check at the top, and you've inserted your first image. Again, go and do that again with the selection tool. Click and drag across the second box. Identify the next image that you want, or select this one. Again, make sure that layer is selected. Go down to the bottom and add your layer mask again. Switch off the link. Select the image. Make sure the image is selected. I'm going to go straight to the Transform tool because I can see already that my image isn't big enough. Go to Scale. Then again, holding down my Shift key, just pull and drag out that photograph to make it bigger, and then move it to where we want and click the checkbox. Again, I'm still on this tool here, so I can go straight to the top, select the next box, select my next image. Again, click on the layer, add a layer mask, switch off the link, go to Transform. Now what I've done is I've highlighted the mask and not highlighted the image. So again, click on the image, go to Transform, And then holding down that shift key again, just make this image bigger. And again, move it. Then click OK. And finally, we've got this final image down the bottom. Again, make sure you're on the selection tool, click and drag. Add the layer mask, make sure you're selected on the image because I'm not, or this layer, which I wasn't. Click on the layer mask, unlink it, click on the image. Transform shortcut is Command or Control T. So again, we can move that and stretch it out to fit the space. And again, move that to where we want. Finally, let's press the check icon. Let's get rid of these guides. So go to View, Guides, Clear Guides. We can zoom out. And there we have that final image. Now you can export this. So go to File, Export. You can quickly export it as a JPEG, or you can export it as a PDF, or a TIFF file, or a Photoshop file. It's completely up to you. Once you've exported it, you can go ahead and use this on social media. You can use this for marketing and, of course, on your website. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.